Hello everyone, I am back with another video. This time I'm going to show you how to overclock your GPU safely. Now it may seem intimidating, but don't be scared, it's very easy. I did mine a few weeks ago and it's been working perfectly fine with no issues, so I will show you today. First of all, you're going to want to install MSI Afterburner. Don't worry, it's a widely used application and I widely recommend it. So many people use it. I mean, when you search it up, it literally says MSI Afterburner is the most used graphics card software. Anyways, with that, you're going to want to install MSI Combustor. Now it's just a little add-on, so then you can do a stress test on your GPU to make sure it's still working correctly and not doing anything weird. Now once you got it installed, go ahead and open it. Once it shows this, of course you want to click yes. Now you can see here a lot of stuff like CPU, memory, voltage, temp. Now just don't worry about that right now. Over here, do not mess with this. I am not sure how to use it, but with all the tutorials I watched, they just said not to touch it, it can cause some very bad stuff. So over here is the main part that we're going to be doing, and then over here is some other stuff that we're going to be messing around with. Now, if you haven't opened Combustor already, you have to click this K here, and it should open this, and you just want to click Run Stress Test. Now I'm just going to put this in the corner over there. Now you will start to hear your fans ramp up and everything. So basically right now it's just running a stress test. You can see the GPU temperature in Celsius Fahrenheit. You can see the frames, you can see the time, of course, frames per second, and the frame times, and load, and all that stuff. Anyways, so to start, we're gonna want to drag this all the way to the right. This is safe, do not worry, many people do this just for a soft overclock. So then, next you're going to want to go ahead and click this check mark, which is apply. Okay, so now we're going to want to look over here now. So then when you're over here, you gotta click this and make sure to only increase the core clock right now. Start by increasing it by 20 every time, making sure that there's no artifacts or any visual glitches or any blackouts and then it turns back on or anything like that. Every time you're gonna want to click this apply check mark to make sure, like I said, artifacts and any visual glitches. Until you hit about 50 or so, then you're going to want to start going up in increments of 10. Then just keep doing this until you feel like it's just right or you see any visual glitches. For me, that was about 150, but then some games don't load up when the core clock is too high and the memory clock is too high. So I would recommend turning it down by a bit, and what I usually go by is 125. So I just say about 20 to 25 I lower it, just so then it's stable enough. And if you do get any game crashes, then you can always just go ahead and lower it by a bit, and then obviously apply. And then we're going to start on the memory clock. This one we're just gonna go in increments of 10 until again you hit that point where it becomes unstable or just not good. Then you're just gonna want to keep looking, making sure there's no artifacts, and making sure the GPU load is pretty high, and you want to look at that GPU temp to make sure it's not going super hot. Oh yeah, and if you notice the speed dropping, that might be because you're focused on the MSI Afterburner, and once you click this again, you'll see it immediately goes up. So just watch out for that. And so my kind of sweet spot is 80, where it doesn't show any artifacts. But again, you're gonna want to lower this down a bit, so I just do mine about 20 below, 20 megahertz, and then it seems pretty stable there. Then when you got all of your settings down, your power limit and temperature limit up, and your core clock and memory clock up until it's stable, and you have it applied, then you're going to want to save it to one of these slots. I already saved into one, that's my main slot, and number two is just my empty slot that I just have plain blank, nothing much. So I'm gonna set mine to 3. So right here, now I have 3, Now I can apply again just to make sure. And that's great, it's gonna work until you shut it off and turn it back on. It's not gonna work anymore. That's why you have to hit this button. On default, it's gonna be off, but if you hover over it, you can see it says that it'll apply it at Windows startup. So you're gonna wanna click this button, so then instead of it being gray, it's blue. So then every single time, it'll default to this slot or whichever slot you have on. And once you have your overclocking done, you can always lock these slots and profiles, but you might want to go back and change it. Anyways, that was my quick tutorial, and hopefully that gets you some FPS. And with that, I'd like to say if you have any questions or it didn't work for you, just put it in the comments. I'll try to reply as fast as I can, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye!